Hello, and welcome back to another episode of ARK Fjordur. What a beautiful morning it is today. And you might be wondering why in the hell I'm staring at a fish basket in the middle of a grassy hill. Well, we're about to find out. I mean, I'm gonna tell you regardless, but to keep a long story short, we're gonna try and tame some dragonfly, some Meganeura today. Technically, Meganeura isn't really a dragonfly, I don't believe. It is a close relative, but not itself a dragonfly. But yeah, thanks to the Kraken's Better Dinos mod, they are now tameable by means of fish baskets. So let's see what we can get and what they do. And that right there is a Dilophosaurus that might come over and mess up my plans in a sec. So I'm going to have to go deal with that. Here, let's just engage and destroy this man. Okay, that wasn't exactly helpful to me because it brought all of the dragonflies all the way over there. Yeah, they're gonna... Yep, that's what I was afraid of. Should have killed them further away. Okay, yep, they're more interested in the body than they are in me. Not anymore. Okay. Oh, boy. I wonder if you can net them in front of the... Well... LOL, yes you can! That's hilarious. Shit. Come here. Got him. Did I catch them all? Why is there still a spoil time? These are dragonflies. Okay, there's one more down here, I think. I think this is the really good one. So theoretically, if I wanted to, I could pick up my net, my fishing bucket. And I could pick up my fishing basket and just set it down right over there, right next to this guy, and, yeah, he'd be screwed because he's trapped in the net. I find that is hilarious. Okay, no armor broken, good to go. But yeah, if you enjoy the video, please go ahead and do me a favor. Hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more. Okay, where did you go? Figured I'd slip that in there while I'm thinking about it, but where did he go? Because I know one of those Meganeura was a 130. And yes, this is what we're doing today. Don't worry, we'll get to some other stuff in a bit, but I really wanted to test this out, because this is something I haven't really been doing. I haven't been taking advantage of all of the things that the mods I have installed allows me to do, all the things we can investigate and experiment, so... Oh boy. So I might as well do some of that, you know? Where the hell did he go? Okay... Oh, there he is. Man, he's way down there. Ow. Put that right up here. I could go get another net, but I don't want to have to fly back to base, you know? Come on. You know what must be done. I could also aggro him and try... Oh, I'm sorry, it's a 135. Come on. Got him. Okay, well, we got ourselves some decent critters now. So let's go ahead and see what this guy can do. Actually, wait, did I, do I have my board? Yes, I do. Alrighty, let's see here. Okay, so we got Meganeura, he's level 135, let's give him some meat. Okay, what does this thing do? Yeah, that's what I thought, okay. So it's a shoulder pet, or something to that effect. I have looked at some of the things that the mod allows these creatures to do, but I have not, like, tested it, I haven't read it in a while. Okay. Oh! Alright. Okay. Oh, shit! We could jump, boys! Ow. Let's go! Oh, that's actually kind of cool. It's like Archaeopteryx, but just a little bit more fun. Also, is it just me, or did he get a lot bigger? I don't know, maybe not. Yeah, thing went from eagle size to, like, borderline primate sized. Oh, shit. Okay, I take reduced fall damage, but I do take some fall damage. That's pretty neat. I like that. Alright. Let's travel back to base, then. Actually, well, I don't want to do that for fear of getting it killed. But yeah, jump height is definitely increased. Duration of time spent in the air is increased. Yeah, I like this. Ooh, we got another one right here. What is this one? A trash! I wonder if you can breed these. Guess we'll find out. Can I only transport them via fish basket? Because that ain't gonna make a whole lot of sense. Got another one. Not sure how many of these I actually want to tame, though. Okay, yeah, we got a male and a female, and we got one over there. Yeah, these are pretty cool. I like these things. This one's a nice color, too. Am I going the right direction? I kind of don't think so. Okay, strictly speaking, no. So let's go this way. That's awesome. I love that. Now, I could just throw out Kamazots and jump on her back and fly over, but where's the fun in that? Let's go for a walk. Boom! Yeah, see, I could easily clear the Iguanodon from a lower angle, so... I like that it buzzes and flaps its wings when you do that, too. I wish it had more of a glide suit function in a way. Like, that would have been really cool, but this is also pretty nice. I wonder how much damage it does. Because that'd be really neat to test out. Okay, we got another Meganeura right here. Level 25, okay. Kill this man. Okay, actually, let me double check to make sure none of its friends are here. He's coming. Oh, yeah, a whole 22 damage. So they do not do a whole lot of damage, but that's not really the point. This is just kind of a cute little shoulder pet. I would say definitely kind of useful for mobility if you're at the beginning of the game, based on what I can tell. You know, nice, it's, it can protect you. Like, it can do some work for you, but... Definitely more of a gimmicky creature. Still, pretty... I like it. It's pretty fun. Boing! I'm on the moon, bitches! Let's go. It's... not... This isn't like the Sonoma crops or whatever the hell it's called from Lost Island, right? Side note. Very cute creature, but... but, like, one of two actually good added creatures in my opinion... Not a statement of fact, but just my opinion. In my opinion, one of two good creatures to come from that map. The other one being the Dinopithecus. Ow! Don't know how clipping my shoes on the spikes did me damage, but okay. But yeah, this is kind of a neat creature. I've been wanting to tame them for a while, you know. And I just really haven't had a free moment to do so. But with everything going the way it's going, might as well. Oh. Okay. And yeah, now see, I got the little on the right hand side of my screen there. I got the little buff from that. Oh, we also off camera, I tamed the oviraptor. I then realized I'm not really sure what the hell I'm going to do with this, but it's just cool to have one. All right. We're going to let these, we're going to throw these guys out here. Inside here. Oh, I like that they land. That's pretty cool. That's really neat. I like that a lot. And yes, they mate boost and they get a pack bonus. That's cool. That's awesome. Okay, yeah, you could probably make a little pack of these and have some fun with that. Can they mate? Yes, they can. Dumb mutation project that doesn't actually accomplish anything, but might be interesting just to see? Question mark? I will say they do kind of all look similar, which is interesting because they didn't when I tamed them, but we'll have to actually examine. No, they're a little different. They got different colored legs. Like I said, Meganeura is technically not a dragonfly, but it really should be considered as such, I think. Like, there's really no distinction that makes it not a dragonfly other than that we didn't want to call it a dragonfly, I think. I'm honestly not sure. It's just like, dude, seriously, the thing is a dragonfly. Just call it what it is. Oh, while I'm thinking about it, let's check this out. This is something that happened while I was breeding my Rexes, and I forgot to mention it before. Remember when we went looking for the evolved Rex or the Tarbosaurus and didn't find anything, so we just turned into a taming spree instead? Something to that effect, I don't remember. Well, it turns out that you can actually breed them. And this is a baby evolved Tyrannosaur. I think it just happens randomly. It's like a 1 or 5% chance when you're breeding Paleo ARK Rexes. I like that it's got feathers. That's really cool. Unfortunately, this came at a stage when we weren't really breeding. When it didn't have the perfect stats of the other ones yet. So unfortunately, that this guy is not going to really amount to much, but I'll let him grow up. We'll let him stay. I'll give him some, might give him that saddle and just let him have some fun with that. Here, we'll give you some raw meat. You know what? Here, we'll give you 300 meat. I will immediately pull that from your inventory like an inefficient scumbag. Gonna do this. Oop. Well, apparently I'll punch him in the side. Really, game? I don't know what the hell has been going on lately. Like, it's happened a couple times now where I'll select a tool that I want to use. The game will act like it's selected and then go, nah, you don't really want to do that, do you? Here, pick this up. But yeah, we're going to quickly update on the base and then we're going to head out again. Doing on that. Okay, so as you can see, we've got more Shadowmanes over here, and now they are joined by these lovely Theris. I went out and tamed some more Theris and a Saurus off camera, because, that needed to happen. And I got two with absolutely, I got one, I think it was, you know what, let's just come over here and look. Here, we're gonna throw this guy out. I'm gonna do that. Don't really need to, but for effect, I will. I really like the markings on him. He looks really cool. Huh. Interesting. Yeah, I'll let him actually get imprinted. So in that respect, here's what we're gonna do. Have this. Make me one, please. And now his feeding needs will be taken care of by the, mother may I thing. What the hell's it called? The S plus nanny. There we go. Literally nothing like what I just said. We're gonna give him this to speed that process along, and also because he's missing some of his imprinting. So, yeah, I really like that. I like the cool the design. That's awesome to see that. Let's see, where is it? Well, one of them is actually the is actually up there currently, I think. Okay, what? Am I carrying one of them? Here, let's try this. I know, I thought I had one. Or, I'm sorry, no. Okay. Interesting. Maybe it's in here. Oh, that reminds me, I should probably clear this out. Dear, oh dear. Yeah, you can see we got some Theri eggs going over here. Okay, yeah. Okay, I see what we're doing here. Yeah, these are they. I thought I was a little further along in the breeding process than I was. That's my mistake. But yeah, these are they. I tamed them out in the goal, out in the autumn zone. Off camera. And this one here has this impressive melee stat post-tame. Total of 40 points into melee. And this one here has the exact same, but into health. So, I lucked out on those two. Really, really good find on them. I dislike that they look very similar, although not quite the same, as you can see. But one thing I forgot to mention, or really notice at the time when I filmed, is that the male and female Therizinosaurus have different color patterns. So that's cool. But yeah, I'm not a huge fan. Like, I like this color pattern. I like the one on the male, specifically. Like, that, like, almost golden cream color with the red. That looks really cool. But honestly, blue and red, which is what we got in the first place, looks so much better. I'm not even going to joke about that. All right, so I need to clear out the babies over here. And I will bring us back in a sec. I'm going to do that off screen because that's going to take a hot second and we got stuff to do, so. Alrighty, we are back. And you will see in front of me here, we've got these lovely guys. We've got some Styggies, and these are from the Kraken's Better Dinos mod. Long story short, basically what they do is they were put in to replace, because the original Pachycephalosaurus, wow, they're all male, seriously? Finally found some with decent level, and all of them are male. Alright, okay, fair enough. Alright, for this we're gonna bring out the secretary. We haven't used her in a while. And basically we're here to tame these because I want to see what they do. They're supposed to basically fill the void of the original Pachy. Let's see if they live up to that. Uh-oh. Come at me! Oh, ouch. Doesn't do a lot of damage, but... Oh! Down. Yes, very good, very good. So, quite a simple tame. Here, we're gonna split this, because I want to try and get the other one. Okay, torpor does drain pretty quick, but not insanely so. Which one were you? Oh. Oof. I like how they some of these modded creatures get their own death animation, which normally was exclusive to the compy or something. Like, most creatures don't get the fun animations. Ow. Oh, love your 4 damage. We love to see it. Oh. This is not the one I was looking at. Alright. Well, I mean, we did knock it out. I'll just leave it there for now. If we want to tame it later, we can. That one was also a male. What is up with that? Alright. Let's put that on my taming count there. Oh, yeah. We're going to be fine. Okay. Oh, okay. Here's the other one. Yep, this is the one. All of them male. So that's like, what, 4 or 5 of them? And they're all male. Damn, talking about a sausage fest, am I right? Admittedly, there is something satisfying about using this method. With the Secretary and the Megalania. Also, a Kraken's Better Dinos change from the original Megalania, by the way. But there is something satisfying about it. Okay, we're gonna get... Yeah, we're gonna get the usual from that. Yeah, Cammy's over there watching from the rocks. But yeah, I want to see what these things can do. I want to start checking out more creatures like this that are part of the mod and see how they work. Which brings me to something else that I wanted to talk about. Next episode, we'll be checking out the Pachyrhinosaurus, which of course is normally a dinosaur that nobody cares about. But not in this case. In this case, there have been some changes made to it that were mentioned to me in the comment section of one of my other videos, and I would really like to see how that plays out. So we'll be looking into that in addition to other things next episode. But for now, we're going to tame these guys up and take a burst spin. If only I had a fish basket. Never mind, that one... You are weak. Wait for it. Oh, down. I will say the Megalania does have one other thing on the Cryolophosaurus that I failed to mention, but... Why am I naming it that? No idea. I like the sounds they made. By the way, you might recognize this dinosaur from Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, I believe it is. Oh boy, I can't move. I'm too fat. Okay. Let's solve that problem. Yeah, you can eat more of those carrots. I don't care. Really? What the hell am I carrying that's so heavy? Oh, all my armor. All right, well. And this thing is really tired. Wait, what? Why is it tired? Here, let's try this. Oh, very, very decent melee damage on this guy. I'm not sure what that translates to in the end, but... Okay, we take that off of the... Okay, here we go. Okay, yeah, very much like the other Packy. Let's see. What does left click do? Well, let us first find a target. Boing. Can we get a little Mario sound effect or something there? Doo, doo. I love it. It's just this some of this nonsensical stuff that I've honestly been missing. Oh, okay. Oh, right, I can't put my thing away because I don't have my weapons anymore. Okay, let's find something to smack. That guy right there will do nicely! Oh, I can't put the secretary away yet, though. Come here. Fight me, coward! What? Oh my. Oh! Oh! That's awesome! I didn't know they could do that. So, okay. So definitely add some early game application if you can tame one of these up real quick. They could gather flint for you. What, can they gather other things? Okay, what does C do? Does C do anything? No. How about X? Control? No. Gonna just ramp up to full. Let's go! Yeah, very much an early game creature with its ability to gather flint and thatch in those extremes. Yep, more thatch there. Can I gather berries? I better be able to. Yep, pretty effectively at that. All right, cool. Okay, I want to smack something. I want to test out my damage. I'm not expecting a whole lot from this thing, but we'll see. Okay, I have the other one, right? Yes. Yes, sir. Oh, that one has really nice health, actually. And again, these are definitely lower tier creatures, but still very good in their own way. I'd really like to fight something. Any chance of waking this guy up? Probably not, huh? What? Ah, you fool! Stop making me look bad, I'm on camera! Uh-oh. Oh! Oh, we got another one over here. Oh, right. All right, let us engage. It's a female, but it's a weak female. It is a low-level female. All right, let us engage in glorious battle. What the hell is that over there? Is that a cave? Oh, what cave is these? Not one I have marked down. Oh boy, oh, we're loading that in. Okay, I'm gonna have to mark this down real quick. Alright, that's about 30-40. So we'll go 30-40. Okay, Mystery Cave has now been noted on the map. Now, let us engage in glorious jousting! Oh, we got a yet another one over there. Man, game. There we go. Okay. I didn't know these guys would be so common in this area. I knew you could find them in a lot of different places, but... Oh. Come here. Sir? Alright. Let us engage. Okay, we do a hot 42 damage. Oh! Oh, God. Uh-oh. And you can see, like the Packy, my torpor is going up, so... What? Why can't I? Meganeura is the true enemy of the mighty Stygimoloch. Still, that was a nice little bit of jousting we got done there. That was a lot of fun. Honestly, the kind of mindless, mundane shit I've been missing in this game a lot of lately. Just going out and having a good time, you know? But, yeah, that's probably gonna do it for today's episode, I think. Yep. Got to showcase this guy. I might put him to work doing something, I don't know. They're kind of neat. Yeah, maybe I'll have a little herd of them running around. I really like them, but I really like them, and yes, indeed, where was I going with that? I don't know. But I do know this. They are a really cool dinosaur, and while they're not a Pachycephalosaurus, they are a relative, if you couldn't tell. Although some experts do argue that indeed what they really are is a baby or juvenile Pachycephalosaur, as the cranium plate, normally the rounded cranium top, hasn't developed as much. And that's certainly an interesting theory. So that could be the truth, or indeed this could just be a different type of dinosaur in the same group. So... but in this game, Stygimoloch is not a juvenile Pachycephalosaur. It is its own entity, so it will be treated with the respect due to such. But, yeah, that's gonna do it for today's episode. Once again, if you enjoyed the video, please hit that like button and subscribe and turn on notice for more. And I will catch you guys in the next one. This has been TBT, signing out.